Hello, loves. Today, meet my friend Tina. She's so beautiful. So today, she's going to be my model, and we're going to teach you lovelies how to lay your lace frontal. And I'm going to do this with the Tieko custom wigs that I make. And yes, it's going to be very nice and simple. And thank you for watching. So let's get right into it. See, I've curled the hair. I colored the hair into a really nice brown mocha color with neutral highlights. And right now I've braided the hair back and I've put the cap and I've put the wig on, as you can see. And I'm using Got to Be Glue to lay the edges down, so that's what I'm gonna use to hold my lace in place. And right now, as you can see, I'm using the dryer to dry it, and it's on cool. And I'm doing this process 3 times. So I'm gonna glue, I'm gonna gel and I'm gonna glue. You know that it's ready when it sticks down on the scalp like so. You see, if it sticks like that when you let it go, then you know that it's done. You see, like that, then you know that it's very well done for you to apply the lace onto the gel so that it can hold. This technique can stay about a week to 2 weeks, depending how well you keep it. So shower correctly, you ladies. This technique does not like water. As you can see, a really good tip that I'm using here is I'm using her baby hair, her natural hairline, to blend with the lace closure. Also, when you're doing a lace closure wig or frontal, which everyone that you're using, make sure that you tweeze the hairline very well. That's the secret to a laid wig. You understand? You know, like laid out like pancake. Yes, laid. If you can get my drift. So once you really pluck the hairline very nicely, it's easy for you to do baby hairs and really get that natural look. As you can see, I didn't really lay too much baby hairs. Well, maybe for some people it may have been a lot. For me, it wasn't. So, you know, over here, if the sides are always a bit difficult to lay, so you want to make sure that if it's not laying, then you just take a little bit of gel like I did so, and then dry it on cool a little bit, and then put the lace down as you just saw me do. So yeah, ladies, I wanted to keep this very simple. So if you have any questions, just go ahead and leave it down below and I will answer you. We're basically done. At this point, we just put some mousse, as you're about to see right now. We put some mousse on. This is not the Motions mousse that you see on the package. It's a different mousse by Beauty on the Edge by Miss Andrea Cheese. Her salon is in Bloomingfield, New York. I met her at the hair show that I went to in my area, and she was amazing. But if you're a stylist, you can get it. But yes, I'm going after I put the mousse on. I will use a wrapping paper, a hair wrapping paper, and mold the hair so that it dries. While I wrap the front, I combed out the hair to smoothing the hair down, and I let it stay there for about 10 to 15 minutes. As you see right here, I have alcohol remover, 91%, and that really cleans up the hair very, very well.
Also, using the towel to dry the excess residue of the gel works very great to remove the residue. So yeah.
So yes, right now I am completely done with the finish style, and ooh, she's feeling herself. Y'all, she's about to, my friend is beautiful. I've known her for about since middle school. She's so beautiful, and I really appreciate her being my model. I love her so much. But yo, she's beautiful, and watch her pop out her celly. Do you see it? She was checking herself out. Thank you, ladies, for watching.
My friend Tina loved her hair, and I hope you loves enjoyed it and learned from this. If you want more videos like these, please subscribe and share. Thank you for watching, loves. Till next week. Bye.